Hello, you are watching Seeker's Notes, and today we are going to do the Panchayati Raj, local government, which is related to 73rd Amendment Act. So I guess you have watched the yesterday's videos in which I did cover about local government in the state of Panchayati Raj. I have covered municipalities. So today we have to see deeper into the government, local government system. So we cover today Panchayati Raj. Whenever you hear about the Panchayati Raj, connected with the 73rd Amendment Act. While if we say about 74th Amendment Act, where it relates to the local government in urban areas. So let's begin with the local government. Actually, the concept of local government has started with Mahatma Gandhi. He believed that in power to all section of people and in grassroots democracy. This is possible only through village panchayat. He said that improve the poorest section of society and the entire society will develop. Though in independent India, one of the directive principle of state policy in the constitution directed to the union and state governments to try to take these steps to organize village panchayat and give them such powers and authority as many as may be necessary to enable them to act as unit of self-government. Panchayati Raj was not taken up seriously by the states. However, they are now given constitutional status. So what did you learn? You learned it that before this 73rd amendment, Panchayati Raj was taken casually. Though it was mentioned in directive principle of state policy, but it was not taken seriously by the state. But now since it has been made constitutional, this Panchayati Raj institution, so of course it has to be followed by states seriously. So there were certain committees which talked about Panchayati Raj, in which we have to study two committees. First is the Balwant Mehta committee. It arrived in 1957, and what he said that decentralized the democracy. It means that from union government cannot rule everywhere from Delhi. They cannot look into the day-to-day issues at village level, because there are thousands of villages in India. So how can it be that Delhi government can take care of the village in Tripura, right? So it will be quite difficult. It would be really very much difficult. So it's been said that this committee, Balwant Rai Mehta committee, suggested that decentralization of democracy will help government. And there should be three tier structure of Panchayati Raj. He mentioned that Panchayati Raj should be set up at three levels. It means three tier system. There should be furnished with sufficient powers and resources as well. These three tiers of Panchayati Raj are: first is Jila Parishad at district level, and Panchayat Samiti at intermediate or block level. Then the last, village or gram panchayat at village level. So he suggested that in this scheme, Panchayat Samiti acted as the middle person between two, this Zila Parishad and this village panchayat. But these Panchayat Samiti were interlinked with each other. As the chairman of this was the member of this, then chairman of this was member of this, likewise they were connected. So these three bodies were interlinked, as the lower body was represented in the higher body through its chairperson. Panchayati Raj of the Balwant Rai Mehta committee pattern was first introduced in Rajasthan. Rajasthan was the first state which adopted this style. Later on, other states went for it. However, Panchayati Raj institution began to decline very soon, owing to government indifference and political interference. This happened after Balwant Mehta committee. Till now, remember, 73rd Amendment Act was not introduced. So after that, Ashok Mehta committee arrived when the Janata government stood in the power. It arrived in 1978, set up by the government to review Panchayati Raj, and submitted its report in 1978. This committee felt that Panchayati Raj had inculcated political awareness among rural masses, and it has not been successfully in carrying out economic development. That time the villages, they were poor and becoming poorer and poorer. Unlike the Balwant Mehta committee, the Ashok Mehta committee suggested two-tier system, the structure of Panchayati Raj. There will Jila Parishad, the district level, and Mandal Panchayat, an administrative unit between village Panchayat and Panchayat Samiti. So you can see, remember the qualification, letters last time, Jila, then Panchayat Samiti, Panchayat Samiti, and then village Panchayat. Here he introduced one more, Mandal. Mandal and Mandal, this Mandal Panchayat, and this was the administrative unit between two, and there will be two tier system. The main emphasis was laid on Zila Parishad, not on the Panchayat Samiti, as in case the earlier committee report. So here it was less focused. However, recommendation of Ashok Mehta committee could not be implemented due to the collapse of Janata government in 1980. So the states like Bihar, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu did not hold election to Panchayat for long. At the same time, many new agencies were set up by the central government, like District Rural Development Agency, to take up the development programs in collaboration with the state government, with Panchayat having role in programs. They themselves hardly had any funds to take up the development projects in the villages. Likewise, this was the scenario before 73rd Amendment Act came into force. Now, when 73rd Amendment Act 1992 was introduced after the crisis of balance, we liberalized our economy and we got change in pattern of our governance too. So 73rd Amendment Act 1992 was passed. What did it do? They made it statutory provisions for the establishment, empowerment, and functioning of the Panchayati Raj institution. Before that, it was not obligatory, but now it was obligatory. Some of the compulsory requirement of the new law were organization of Gram Sabha, it was compulsory, and then creation of three-tier Panchayati Raj structure at the Zilla, block, and village level. So they were inspired by who? Balwant Mehta committee. And almost all post, all levels to be filled by direct election, because they have to, government always is good when chosen by the people themselves. So minimum age for contesting election of Panchayati Raj institution is till now 21 years. Then what did this say? The 73rd Amendment Act is also further introduced that post of chairman at the Zila and block level should be filled by indirect election. There should be reservation, indirect election, well, we'll see this, and there should be reservation of seats of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe as it was in urban areas, and similar quantities like urban for women. Reservation, one third of the total membership, and the state commission, the state election commission shall be, you know, set up in each state to conduct election to Panchayati Raj institution, and the tenure of Panchayati Raj institution shall be 5 years. If dissolved earlier, fresh election will be held within 6 months. This I repeat that anything which is elected directly by people, it is elected directly by people, it can be dissolved in and nothing can be done with this. And a state finance commission is set up in each state every after 5 years. And this is 74th amendment discussed above. You can see just IAS 9 series. This episode, you will get all the information about that. some of the provisions which are not binding on the state but only guidelines are that giving voting rights to the member of central and state legislature to these bodies. You see that, and you will see a triangle. In this first triangle, speak about that in that video, but I would repeat it again. If state government want, state government find a potential member in its legislative assembly or in Lok Sabha, they can request to that member that please, we need your assistant in this level of village panchayat. So that member can be there. So giving voting rights to the member of the central or state legislature in these bodies. Not only that, providing reservation for backward classes. Remember, this is not scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, this is backward classes. So for these, this is the compulsory provision, and for them it's voluntary. Then Panchayati Raj institution should be given financial powers in relation to taxes, levy fees, and the effort shall be made to make panchayat autonomous body. It means if they decide something for a village, so it's probably accepted. Composition of panchayat. So three tier based, we have said village and intermediate and district. Exemptions from the intermediate tier is given to the small state which are having less than 20 lakh population. Then panchayat at village level. This is the basic and grassroots level. Nothing can be further subdivided except just mohallas and like that. So village is the grassroots level of for our government to work. And this grassroots village panchayat, it can be further divided into three parts. It is known as the Gram Sabha, this direct symbol of democracy, then Gram Panchayat and Nyaya Panchayat. We'll see it in detail just now in Gram Sabha. Recognition to Gram Sabha is necessary as an institution of direct democracy. It means these people are directly elected to from the village, and they are vote, they have vote of this direct vote of people of the village, from the village, and is an important feature of the 73rd amendment. This one, that is, it's an institution of direct democracy. Gram Sabha consists of all adult residents within a village or group of village who is considered as an adult, whosoever is older than 18 years, and thus it is the only institution of direct democracy in the country. And then generally two meetings of Gram Sabha are held every year. In those meetings, the Gram Sabha, as the general body of the people, hear annual statement on account, audit, administrative report of panchayat. It also recommends new development projects to be undertaken by the panchayat, and also helps in identifying poor people of the village so that they may be given the economic assistance. So Gram Sabha is directly like Lok Sabha in the center. So these are directly elected by the people, directly elected, and they have at least, they should have at least two minimum meetings. And they are responsible for auditing and administrative reports, and they can recommend new policies for development. Then Gram Panchayat, the lower tier of Panchayati Raj system in the country, is the village level panchayat, and it is also known as in the most of the state as the Gram Panchayat. The members of the Gram Panchayat are directly elected by the people like Lok Panchayat, and the number of the members of Gram Panchayat is fixed on the basis of village population. Hence it differs from the panchayat to panchayat. Election is on the basis of single members constituency. As already mentioned, 1/3 of the total numbers of seats are reserved for the women, and some of the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe, including 1/3 women of scheduled caste and scheduled tribe. Chairperson of Gram Sabha Panchayat are also called by different names in different states, like Sarpanch, Pradhan, and President. There is a vice chairperson also. Both are elected by the members of the panchayat. The Gram Panchayat generally hold their meeting once in a month. Panchayat at all level constitutes committee for transaction of their business. Nyaya Panchayat, these are judicial panchayat and are reminder of ancient village panchayat that settle local disputes. They are set up to provide speedy and inexpensive justice, like Sarpanch, they are sitting here. One Sarpanch, Dusra Sarpanch, second Sarpanch, and third Sarpanch. A person comes with dispute with this person and they say something, and that thing is like law. This tenure and their tenure is between 3 years to 5 years as determined by the state. It depends between 3 to 5. And Nyaya Panchayat generally deal with petty civil and criminal cases and can impose fine up to ₹100 only. There are no lawyer to plead the cases in Nyaya Panchayat. Parties to dispute argues their own causes. So here no need of lawyer. They can talk and keep their sides. Then Panchayat Samiti, these are the second level of Panchayat. First we Gram Panchayat, we were we covered till now. The second or middle tier of Panchayati Raj is Panchayat Samiti, which provides a link between the Gram Panchayat and the Jila Panchayat and District Panchayat. The strength of Panchayat Samiti also depends on population of the in the Samiti area. In Panchayat Samiti, some members are directly elected, some members, and some come from the this Gram Panchayat. Their presidents, they come into that, or chairperson, not president, actually chairperson. However, all the sarpanch of Gram Panchayat are not members of Panchayat Samiti, of course, at the same time. The number varies from state to state and is rotated annually. This means that chairperson of some Gram Sabha in a Samiti area are the members of the Panchayat Samiti at the time. In some Panchayat, members of the Legislative Assembly and Legislative Council as well, members of the Parliament who belong to the Samiti area are co-opted as its member. Chairperson of Panchayat Samitis are generally elected from among the directly elected member. Functions of Panchayat Samiti, this plays a bit, interlinked role, like intermediary between Gram Sabha and Jila Panchayat. These Panchayat Samitis are the hub of developmental activities. They are headed by the Block Development Officer, BDOs. Some functions are entrusted to them, like agriculture and land improvement. These things are taken care of by them. Watershed development, social and farm forestry, technical, vocational education, etc. And the second type of functions relate to the implementation of some of the specific plans as directed by the government, schemes or programs to which funds are earmarked. It means that the Panchayat Samiti has to spend money only on the specific project. The choice of location or beneficiaries, however, available to the Panchayat Samiti. Then Zila Parishad. Zila Parishad at the district level, and there is the uppermost tier of the Panchayati Raj system. This institution has some direct elected members whose number differs from the state to state, as also based on the population. Chairperson of Panchayat Samitis are ex officio members of Jila Parishad often, and members of Parliament, Legislative Assemblies and councils belonging to the districts are also nominated member of Jila Parishad. The chairperson of Jila Parishad, called Adhyaksha or President, is elected from among the direct elected members, and the vice chairman, chairperson, is also elected similarly. Jila Parishad meeting are conducted once in a month. Special meetings can also be convened to discuss special matters. Subject committees are also formed. Functions of Jila Parishad. Jila Parishad links Panchayat Samitis within the district. It coordinates their activities and supervises their function. It prepares district plan and integrates Samiti plan into district plan for submission to the state government. Then Zila Parishad looks after the development works of entire district. Not only that, it undertakes a scheme to improve agriculture production, exploit ground water resources. So here it is extended rural electrification and distribution, and initiate employment generating activities, construct roads and other public services. It also performs welfare functions like relief fund during natural calamities, scarcity, establishment of orphanage and poor homes, night shelter, welfare of women and children, etc. In addition, Jila Parishad performs perform functions entrusted to them under the central government and state government sponsored program. For example, Jawahar Rozgar Yojana is a big centrally sponsored scheme for which money is directly given to the district to undertake employment generating activities. So what we learned, that members of panchayat are directly elected. If state decisions, state decides, member of the state legislature or parliament may also be represented in district and middle level of panchayat. The middle level panchayat are also generally known as the panchayat samiti. Provisions have been made for the inclusion of the chairperson of the village panchayat in the block and district level panchayat. The reserved seats are allotted by rotation to different constituency in panchayati area. State legislature can provide for further reservation for other backward classes in panchayat. Not only that, if we see about tenure, it's for 5 years, but can be dissolved, and election have to be held within 6 months. State level election commissioner state level election commissioner direct the election, control the election, and is responsible for the election. Schemes of economic development and social justice with regard to 29 important matters such as agriculture, primary and secondary education, health and sanitation, drinking water, rural housing, welfare of weaker sections, social forestry, and so forth may be made by them. Then functions of the panchayati raj, the civic functions of relating to the sanitation, cleaning or public roads, drainage and ports, public toilets and lavatories, primary health care, vaccination, supply of drinking water, constructing public wells, street lighting, social health and primary and adult education, etc. are obligatory functions of village panchayat. The optional functions depend on the resource of the panchayat. If they have fund, they can do it, or they cannot do it. Then what did the 73rd amendment change in panchayat? The 73rd amendment did is that scope of the function of the gram panchayat was widened. Such important functions like preparation of annual development plan of panchayat area, annual budget, relief in natural calamities, removal of encroachment on public lands, implementation and monitoring of poverty alleviation programs are now expected to be performed by panchayat. Selection of beneficiary through gram sabha, public distribution system, non-conventional energy sources, improved chulas, biogas plant have also been given to the gram panchayat in some states. So sources of income, gram panchayat earns from levying taxes. It can be house tax or tax on cattle, immovable property, lighting tax, and these are the tax or fees levied by the panchayat. Panchayat can also levy entertainment tax on temporarily stationed theater, tax on animals and non-mechanically propelled vehicles filed for hire, like animals and vehicles both, like municipalities. Gram panchayat also receive funds as income from property owned by them as common grounds, like jungles, cattle ground, etc. The sale proceeds of dung, refuse and carcasses, dead bodies of animal is also retained by the gram panchayat. This they also receive their share in land revenue from state. So then panchayat samiti, how does it earn? Can impose tax facilities provided on them as water for drinking and irrigation purpose, lighting arrangement, tolls and bridge maintained by them. The property of panchayat samiti include public building roads constructed, maintain out their fund, and all land other property transferred to them by the government. Panchayat receives income from the property vested in them. They also receive grant from the state government. Fund are transferred by jila panchayat or state government along with the scheme to be implemented by the intermediate institution of panchayati raj. Not only that, jila parishad are also authorized to impose taxes. They may impose taxes on person carrying on business on rural areas for 6 months, taxes on brokers, commission agents in the market established by them, also tax on sale of goods on these markets. The tax on land revenue can also be imposed by jila parishad. When the development of schemes are entrusted to them, necessary funds are also provided. They receive grant from state, donation from charitable institution, and may also raise loans. So thank you. This this is all about Gram Panchayat. I know if it bothers you, please watch the previous video then this one. I think you will get the point and concepts clear soon. So thank you. Please like, share and subscribe. For feedback, leave a comment below or email us noteseekers@gmail.com.